Hello and welcome to this review of Disney Pixar Plug and Play by our good friends at Jack Specific Plug and Play TV Games. Yes, fantastic. I believe this one comes with five or six games. I think it's five. I think there's about five or six games on this. Pretty darn cool. All from our favorite films, Bug's Life, Toy Story, and Monsters, Inc. I know everybody loves Monsters, Inc. and Toy Story, so you can't go wrong. Plus, I really like Bug's Life, so I'm really hoping these games are really, really good. Can you guess the year this was made? 2006? You damn right it was. Yes, 2006 was when this came out, so it's over 12 years old. Crazy. I know, it's so crazy. What is it like? Same as the rest of them, to be honest. The joystick is mushy-ish, but this one feels quite solid and responsive. It definitely has an up, down, left, right. Definitely has that. I can feel it when it hits it. There's no buttons to speak of, but it feels a lot better than the other ones, anyway. It's got an A and B button. Classic A and B button. Fantastic. Can't go wrong with that. It also has a menu button at the front, and also a power switch, which... there you go. Awesome. You know when it's running. Fantastic. Fun times. This one does require four AA batteries, as usual. Again, no clip for the battery cover, so you do need to screw it in and make sure it's secure, otherwise your batteries are going to fall out while you're playing it. On the back it says Jack Specific, Disney, Pixar, 2006, Jack Specific Inc., Malibu, CA, 6 volts, adult assembly required, made in China, tvgames.com, and it's not recyclable. It's not always to say that. There is some sort of serial number at the bottom. You will not be able to see that, I don't think, because of sun glare. It's very sunny. The weather in the UK has been crazy lately. We've had sunshine pretty much non-stop for months now. Not used to it. It's very nice, actually. Every day is really warm. I don't really know much else about this. This was just a couple of quid on eBay. I picked this up. You know, you guys know I like to collect my plug and plays. So, I don't know much about it. So, let's have a look at the games and see what they are like.
Jack's Pacific. Plug and Play TV Games by Handheld Games. 2006 Disney Pixar. I know, Pixar. Pixar of all people. Disney Pixar, look at all this. Look at it. Good stuff. Disney Pixar Classics. Press any button to continue. Now, how many games do we have? Let's have a look. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 options. 5. Wait, what? Okay, so it throws them in. That's pretty cool. There's a play and there's a demo button. That's interesting. Let's find out what the options are first. Human players, 2. Oh, right, so you can take in turns every time you die, I assume. That's pretty interesting. High scores, difficulty, normal and hard. That's pretty good as well. I like this. Sound, music, sleep mode, whatever that is. Let's turn that off, because we don't want that accidentally on. And clear game data. Pretty interesting. I wonder how much it saves. Whether it requires batteries or not. It's always curious to know about those things. But hey, at least it has these options. That's pretty interesting. I would actually prefer sound and music volume options, but having the option to turn them on and off separately, that's still something in my book. Alright, so let's find out what demo is. Moving day, show me a demo. Oh, it's a sizzler reel type thing. Oh, that's kind of cute. So you can see what the games are like before you can play them. That's actually quite interesting. Plus, it's also great for displays, so for example, if you were selling this, you could throw the demo mode on. You don't even have to play it. That's actually pretty cool. Doesn't last very long, though. Doesn't last very long at all. Pretty cool, though. Alright, so, as that is the first game, let's go with Toy Story Moving Day. I wonder what this game's about. Collect the batteries to keep your car charged. Don't get caught by... The evil dog from the first film. collect rockets to launch to the bonus round. That sounds pretty interesting. Time, 1 minute 10. Score, 0. Whatever that means. Alright, joystick. How does the joystick feel? Well, it's definitely usable. Oh, let's do this. Kind of reminds me of the Scooby-Doo plug and play. Oh, I missed the battery. Oh, yeah, you can slow down for it, can't you? Ah... Alright, let's keep going. Let's do this. Yeah, and you can slow down to grab the rocket. Oh, you've got to build up the rocket. It just says collect the rocket for the bonus round, but no, you've got to keep collecting the rockets. Right, where's our battery meter? Oh, the power is at top left. I'm keeping an eye on the game, not so much the, anything else. Oh, we've almost got enough rockets, but I guess we have to get all of them. We have to get all of them. Oh, as you turn the corner, level 2. Oh, that's pretty interesting, actually. And yes, it does reset our meter. Oh, we've got oil slicks on the floor now. I guess these are just points. We don't really care about that. I forsaken the battery for the rocket. I am curious about this bonus round, so let's go out of the way and try getting that, shall we? I think we need one more for the bonus round. Now, let's hope we don't miss it. Checkpoint. Checkpoint system as well. That's a... Oh! To infinity and beyond. What? 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 Alright, you've got to follow these for bonus points. That is pretty impressive. And you can obviously... Oh, we didn't get them all. Because I went too fast. Ah. That is pretty interesting. So, wait, you've got multiple uses in your rocket? This is an interesting take, though. This is definitely an interesting take on the, one of the final scenes of the film. Nice turn in the corner. I don't know how many levels there are. And to be honest, I don't want to spoil them for you. Plus, they eventually get hard, so we're going to lose eventually. I'd rather not find out my limits. Oh, no. But anyway, yes, that was moving out the Toy Story game. Pretty darn cool. We'll hit them. There you go. We just hit the menu button and did that. I love how I was like going to describe myself doing it, but I'd already pressed the button. As if there wasn't enough of a delay because of the way I record. Yes, there is like a second delay. So, for example, I'm going to press right in a moment. I'll say now when I do. And you'll see the delay. There is like 1 second delay. He said. Right, ready? I'm going to press it now. So as you can see, there is a slight delay between what I see and what I react to what you see and what you hear me react to. But it's just the way I record, and I'm not going to change it, so it's just something to bear in mind. Anyway, let's go for Bug's Life, because I actually really enjoyed Bug's Life. I'm devastated they never got a Bug's Life 2, even though it was teased at the end of Toy Story 2. Rude. And also, I actually enjoyed the video game for N64 and also PS1. I had it on PS1 before I got it on the N64. It looks better on a PS1. So this is Flick's Food Finder. Instructions. Collect all the things. Avoid all the things. Okay. You are at the offering stone. Food type, the corny man's. The acorn thing. Food remaining 20. Okay. We can jump. B doesn't appear to do anything. We can't walk that far unless I had to jump. No? Do I have to jump? Oh! I'm an idiot! I thought that was part of- He had to jump! Good job. Oh, can I just take that from him? Oh! Get dunked! What?! And he steals it from you! That's hilarious. Okay, this is actually pretty fun. I like this. This is a fun platformer. I'm just going to donk you, get some points, donk you. And this reminds me of the video game PS1 now, because you have to jump on all these. That's actually pretty interesting. I do like that. Oh, what's that? What's that? Oh! So I pressed B to dig. They didn't tell me about that in the menu. Let's keep an eye out for these. What's this? The cliffs. Oh, are they different menus, or... You were at the cliffs. Food type berry. What is this? Oh, this is pretty interesting. All right, there's a falling of doom, I assume. Ooh, almost. The joystick is actually quite responsive. I'm finding it very easy to play, and as we're on composite, there isn't actually that much delay. It changes dynamic music. See, it's little details like that that make me very happy, and what's that supposed to be? Oh, I have to keep an eye out for... Okay. That's pretty interesting. So we gotta keep an eye out for that. I'm just gonna keep dunking them on the head. Oh, there's one here. Oh. No, I'm gonna stay here because I want to get three more. I'm not sure. I think I'm supposed to just get it all. There's no timer, so... Ooh, we've got that going for us. Put a donk on it. Let's go have a look for the other free food, shall we? That's to the offering stone. I wonder if it... Ooh. I wonder if it saves progress. So if I left here, would I still have this much... Berrymans? I don't know, but we need one more. And there it is! Did I... Oh! And we win? I don't get it. What do we win? Oh my goodness. Wait, am I supposed to just... Oh, I can only hold up to 10. Okay! That's pretty... Okay, so this is actually a very, very good game. It's a very good, fun little platform. It's a basic platformer. And it's got varying different levels. I've got 3 on me now. Let's go to the grassy fields. Yeah, and I've still got my 3 on me now, so it does keep progression. Oh, there's another one. Let's go grab that. Oh, that's really, really cool. See, I'm very impressed by things like this. Kids would love this type of game. Let's go grab this one up here. Nom nom nom. Oh, wrong button. There we go. Still pretty cool. The offering stone. Does that mean there's only 15 left here? Oh, food remaining 15? I see. So if I take that one and leave... Alright, it says 17. It should say, like, 14. Yes, it does! Alright, so our objective is to just get all the food and all the lands. Pretty impressive. See, I don't know what happens when you reach the end, but I don't want to show you guys, so let's, move on to the next game. That's pretty that's fun. I do like that one. Boost Scared. We're on Monsters, Inc. now. I did like that. So let's, continue. What? Oh, must have been a previous owner. I guess that is telling me who previously had this. Like, whoever previously had this had some progression. So it does save even with new batteries. Pretty impressive. Let's start a new game then, shall we? Okay, so level 1. We have to avoid... Oh, God. We have to avoid the big evil guy, the yellow guy, and the purple guy. We have to scare... Purple mama, two skinny, green guy, red guy, and, I don't get it. I don't get it. I'm not gonna pretend to understand. Ready? Yeah, I'm ready. So I'm going to scare this guy. How do I scare him? Do I just go, boo? Boo! What was that scream? What was that scream? I don't know what the... Alright, so there's nothing back here. Wait, what does A do? Oh, I'm disguised. And then I go, woo, scary, because I'm a child. Aha. Okay. So if I walk up to this guy, he shouldn't get scared, right? Right, so he doesn't get scared. Right, we avoid Mr. Yellow Guy, don't we? I don't quite remember. Oh, but we scare her as well. Yeah, not scared by me. How horrifying, right? Oh, they found me. Pretty cool. Oh, but we're meant to find, I forget their names. Do you know how many years it's been since I've watched Monster Inc? I found him. I don't get it. I don't get it. What? Hello? You were nabbed by Randall. Wait, what? What? Wait, what? I'm, okay, fair enough. Alright, let's go. Scared ya. Scared ya. Oh, oh. Can I scare the green guy? I can't remember. Yeah, I can scare him. Right, run away, quick. Hi, Mr. Yellow Guy. By the way, scared. Scared. You saw nothing. Scared. Scared. You see nothing. Okay, so I did a thing. I don't know what I did, but I did a thing. So it's the opposite of basically the premise of the original Monster Inc. was that you're meant to scare children, and then they realize they get more energy by making them laugh. Alright, so I've scared enough people. The opposite. Scared enough monsters. And now I can go to Sully. I think his name's Sully. Is this one Sully? I think his name's Sully. I can't remember. Oh, save game. Okay, that's different. Alright, then we got level 2, so where you do the similar thing, I guess. I'm ready! Spooky. So I assume I don't get nabbed if I just go, hi. Wait, okay, so you do get caught even if you're in disguise, just don't touch them. Fair enough. That's okay. That makes sense. But yeah, this is a pretty interesting game. I do actually quite like this one. It's a little bit of a stealthy type, puzzle type game. Find the best ways to avoid all these guys, pretty easy. It shows how alerted they are. There you go, boom. And on to the next one. Scare them. Scare this guy. Come here. Oh. Oh, it's getting... I'll just scare these guys. I need to scare Mr. Redman's. Avoid you. Scare the Redman's. Oh. Go around the red. Go around the yellow man's. Through here. Awesome. So I'm just going to do this level pretty quick because I think I've got a good handle of how to play this game. Oh. Ooh. I need to get Mr. Redman's. Go, 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 go. Haha, and we won a cookie. So yeah, the objective is to scare all of them, basically. Oh, I think we're going this way instead. Interesting. I like this level design. It's not too bad. It's pretty impressive. Aha! And we win. The sound effects are a little bit annoying. Yeah, let's save. Why not? Alright, so that was Monsters, Inc. I forgot the name of the game. It was the Monsters, Inc. game, basically. Boo Scare. That's the one. Next is... Oh, another Monsters, Inc. game. Well, that makes sense then, because I would have just called them the Toy Story game and Bugs Life game, but now there's two Monsters, Inc. games. So we've got Slamador. Is that like Whack-A-Mole? Probably, let's find out. How to play. A to slam, B to save. So we slam it on the scrubs, save the child and the other guy. The other guy that I forget the name of, but I'd remember if someone mentioned it. bring the kid to the bottom. Press A to continue. Okay. What? Oh! Okay. Slam. Wait, what? What? I think I'm missing... I get knocked out by those guys. Yeah, I can't slam on him. But if I go over them, I just... So I get knocked out when I close a door on him. What? I'm confused. Wait, so why do I want to slam the door on them again? I'm confused. Wait, what? I don't get it. I'm not even going to pretend to get it. Red is bad. Red you get knocked out with. Am I supposed to slam the door on him or something? I'm so confused. I'm missing something. I'm going to restart the game, and I'm going to have a little bit of a read. Slam... A to slam. A to slam. B to save. Oh, so I was pressing B. I was trying to save the bad guys. Alright, so how do I slam on them then? Let's press A, apparently. Alright, let's do it. Oh. I'm here. I saved you. Oh, there we go. Get wrecked. I did a good. I think. Ah. I got this. Alright, so, actually, now that I know what I'm doing... Oh, that's where the bad guys are coming. Alright. Yeah, what... And then once I've got her, I'm supposed to... rescue her somehow. And I accidentally... Oh, bring it to the bottom! Bring it to the bottom! I remember now. See, memories. Memories don't work. Right, so what we do is we grab her... Kill him. Alright, so this is actually... Okay, I like this game. It's simple. Pretty easy to do. Bring it to the bottom. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And if we leave it too long, things are bad. So yeah, we mash the A button. Just knock all the scrubs out. No one likes you. Ooh. Alright. There we go. Come on. Come on, kid. I need to rescue you. Let's do this. Wait. I don't see her. I'm gonna knock him out. There you go. Get wrecked. Alright, so there's no kid on this level by the looks of it. That's fine. So I'll just dance around and hope for the best. Oh, here we go. There you go. Saved you. Aren't I the best? Wait, did he just throw... Oh, he's throwing snowballs at people. That's awesome. So he helps you out. Sid! Is it Sid? Is it Sid? Sully and Sid? I can't. It probably isn't. But hey, I'll... Oh, knocked myself out. I'm good. That's fine. Oh, I'm here. I'm here. There you go, kid. Yeah, I think I understand this game. It's pretty fun. Pretty easy to play. Let's move on to the next game. That's the options. Alright, so the last game now is Toy Story. The second game of Toy Story. Sarge's Drill Team. Let's have a quick look at that, shall we? Alright, so it looks like there are previous games on it. Alright, so level one. Use the... What is that, fridge? I don't know. Use the box thing to make stairs. Bring the soldier guy to the flag. Okay. I can jump. Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh, no. Evil blues. Can I just go down here? No, I can't. That's fine. Right, so what do I do here? I'm gonna imagine I need to... I'm just gonna... Am I not supposed to touch them? Oh, I can touch them. Oh, bring them to here! I get you. Right, hold on. So if I bring them over here... Does this summon them over here? Like lemmings. Like lemmings! Like lemmings! Alright, pretty cool. So, this is a little bit like lemmings then. So, yeah, oh, this is lemmings! Okay! It's like army men versions of lemmings. Move your backside! Very annoying noise. Very loud. In my headphones. You win! Soldier's finished! 5. Okay! Pretty cool. Alright, level 2, throw the marble, I think that's a marble, to the green thing. Alright! Alright, I got this. Oh. Alright, how do I... Do I just make him eat it? Oh! Alright, come on. Alright, he's got it. Alright, I'll just move on to these ones before we get the, there you go. You take that, you scrub. I think... They need that for that, don't they? There you go. Thrown that at that. I mean, they should just be able to make the way over here, I think. Oh, they can't climb that. Okay. I'm going. There's no way of me moving faster. I want them to move faster, but I can't go any faster. Unless they can jump up marbles. We'll try that later. I'm just gonna keep pressing jump. I think it moves me a little bit faster. Here you go, come up! Move! Move, you dogs! Let's do this. That is quite an annoying noise. They could have done a little bit better with that. Right. Oh, move. Come on, you apes. Do you want to live forever? I mean, you're toys, so technically you do, but you do suffer from wear and tear. But I suppose you could repair yourself. I don't know. I mean, we saw in the first Toy Story, they were repairing themselves, weren't they? They were fixing themselves up. They do not climb over the marbles. And let me guess. Oh, no! I bet they get stuck in it! No! No! Hurry up! I bet they get stuck in it! No! No! Don't you dare! Don't you dare! Oh, no, they're just stuck in place. That's okay. Oh, I just... Damn. Wait, what? What? Okay. Okay! Ah, it's even better, I guess. They're just stopping it. They can't get through it because it's... It's... I don't know, barbed wire? Move your butt! That noise is very annoying. But! I really enjoy this game because I absolutely adore lemmings. So that is pretty darn awesome. Push or pull the H to move them. So yeah, it just offers different levels and different ways of completing it. So you push that. Obviously you pick up that, throw that at that. Oop. Can they not get over that? I don't know, let's find out. I'm gonna assume not. Let's assume they can't get over it. Nope, they can't. So basically I need to get them to go over all of them, basically. Oh well, we know how to finish this one. Pretty easy enough. Let's nip over to the main menu. So yeah, that are the 5 games for Disney Pixar. I'm gonna keep playing this for a little bit of while, and then I'll give you my final thoughts right about now. Alrighty, so what are my final thoughts on Jak Specific Plug and Play, TV Games, Disney Pixar, with 2 games for Toy Story, 2 games for Monsters, Inc., and 1 game for Bug's Life? You could have done 2. Pretty darn fun, all of them. Played them for a good while. I didn't complete all of them because some of them got pretty darn difficult further on, especially the racing one, the first Toy Story game, the moving house one. That is, it gets pretty darn difficult later on because you've got to balance speed slowing down to pick up all the battery unlocks and stuff. And I love going for the bonus rounds. You know what I'm like when I'm playing Crash Bandicoot. I always go for the bonus every time, so I'm always slowing down to try and get the rockets, but then the dog's after me and all the oil slicks. It's just, it's so crazy. Very, very fun. Every single game on here, I absolutely adore. They're very, very fun. There's, you know, the little take on Whack-A-Mole with the Slam-A-Door. That's pretty damn fun. Very, very easy. It does get a little bit more difficult with the, the hardest part is literally just getting hit by the doors constantly. Not so much the slamming of the doors into enemies. That's not really a big deal. They're nothing. They're just there. You just get extra points for slamming them. I don't know why there's clones, but there are. I really enjoyed the Lemmings clone at the end, with the exception of the sound. Some of the sounds were a little bit loud and annoying and obnoxious, but that was mostly because I was wearing headphones. It'd probably sound a little bit better if you got a TV and you're like, on the other side of the room. So it's not as horrible and down your ears. But yeah, that's pretty darn cool. The Toy Story games, they were pretty darn fun, both of them. The Monsters, Inc. games, both of them were fun as well. The puzzle one, not so much. That's probably the weakest game, the little puzzle maze type one, where you're just running around, you've got to scare monsters, which is a little bit of a reversal on the movie itself, which is pretty darn cool, which is amusing, because at the end of the film, of course, the kid scares the crap out of everyone, but then they realize that laughing seems to make more power, so they make kids laugh at night. Much to parents' chagrin, because no one wants their child up at night. Go to sleep. You're going to be annoying in the morning. Disney Pixar movies for you. But anyway, yeah, and the Bug's Life game reminded me of the N64 PS1 game, which is pretty darn cool. Really enjoyed that one. It's very easy. It was just a basic platformer. All the games, very, very approachable, very fun for children. I highly recommend this plug and play. It's very, very good. If you can pick it up for a couple of quid and you love Disney Pixar films, or you've got a child that loves Disney Pixar films, get it for them. This is absolutely fantastic and I highly recommend it. It only requires 4 AA batteries, which you can buy at Poundland. You can buy a whole bunch of Poundland. So this has got hours upon hours of entertainment for a child. And it's very fun. Very easy to find. Pretty cheap as well. Go pick one up. I highly recommend it. I'll see you guys next time. Take care, survivors.